A very good morning, students. I hope you all are enjoying your online classes. In continuation of the study, we are here with a new lesson, that is the Shepherd's Treasure. It is the third lesson of your supplementary book, and this lesson is an Iranian folk tale. Okay, at first we will try to understand what is the meaning of the title. The first one, Shepherd. Shepherd means a person who take care of sheep or pets. Okay, and treasure means a very valuable things. Any valuable thing is known as treasure. Okay, this lesson, as I have already told you, that it is an Iranian folk tale. Iran means it is a name of country, and folk tale means a kind of story which is told by the previous generation, means told by the ancestors to the younger generation orally, means they are not written for, they are not in written form. Okay, but this time too many authors have tried to write down these kind of folk tales, and this is one of the example of a folk tale. Okay, there are some clues about the story, as you can see here. A poor shepherd once lived in Iran. Though uneducated, he was very wise and helpful. The king decided to meet him in disguise. Okay, we will read the first paragraph. In a village in Iran, there once lived a shepherd. He was very poor. He did not have even a small cottage of his own. He had never been to school or learned to read and write, for there were very few schools in those days. Okay, before starting this lesson, I want to tell you that this story tells us that how human values are important, like honesty, wisdom and humanity, and how these qualities are always rewarded. In our previous chapter, in Taro's reward, you have already seen that Taro also got the reward for his hard work, for honesty and for thoughtfulness. In this lesson, we will also came to know that how the shepherd got reward for his honesty and wisdom. Okay, in this first paragraph, there is a small introduction about a shepherd who used to live in a village of Iran. Okay, he was very poor and he don't have any house, means he don't have even a small cottage of his own. Cottage means a small hut, means he don't have any house, and he have never went to school to read and write. And because there was a reason behind that, because there were not too many schools in those days. As I have told you that this is an ancient story, this is an ancient folk tale. Okay, now we will move to the next one, second paragraph. Though poor and uneducated, this shepherd was very wise. He understood people's sorrow and troubles and helped them face their problems with courage and common sense. Many people came to him for advice. Soon he became famous for his wisdom and friendly nature. The king of that country heard about him and thought of meeting him. So what happened? He, as we have already discussed, that he was uneducated, he don't know how to read and write. Okay, and he is too poor that he don't have any house. Okay, but even being an uneducated person, he was very wise. He was not educated, but he was very wise. He can understand the sorrow of different people. Sorrow means sadness or gloom, we can say that. And troubles means problems, means he can understand the problems of different kinds of people, and he has the courage and common sense to solve these problems. Many people came to him for advice soon. He became famous for his wisdom and friendly nature. Means being an uneducated person, he was wise enough to solve the problems of other people. That is why he became very famous, and people used to come to meet him for solving their problem. And soon after, he became very famous, and the king of that country also heard about his wisdom and about his common sense.